celebrate the Feast of the Epiphany. We have a few reminders as we enter into our worship this morning. Please turn off your cell phone and other electronic devices. The readings and music today can be found in the hymnal and worship aid. Today, we celebrate the rite of acceptance with our brothers and sisters who are preparing to enter into the church at Easter. Our lector for this Mass is Kim McGuire, and our presider for this Mass is Father Tom. Let us stand and take a few moments to turn and greet one another. Now, let us join our hearts and our voices in our opening song, We Three Kings, number 105 in your hymnal, verses 1 and 5. We Three Kings, 105, verses 1 and 5.
Travis far, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Glorious now, behold him rise, King and God and sacrifice. Alleluia, alleluia, sounds through earth and skies.
Let us begin our celebration of the Epiphany the way we begin all of our prayer, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with each of you this morning.
And with your spirit.
And I invite you now to please be seated for our rite of acceptance. Today, as we celebrate those who came a distance to find the baby Jesus, the light of the world, we celebrate with those in process of joining our faith community and accepting the Catholic faith. As we welcome them, we remember that we are all seekers of faith as we gather in the presence of Christ. I now ask the confirmandi and candidates, along with their sponsors, to come forward. And I ask you, what is your name?
Colleen.
Ksenia.
Glennis.
Max.
Idiana.
Joseph.
And what do you ask of God's church?
Faith.
What does faith offer you?
Eternal life.
God is our creator, and in him all living things have their existence. God enlightens our minds so that we may come to know and worship him. God has sent a faithful witness, Jesus the Christ, to announce to us what he has seen and heard, the mysteries of heaven and earth. Like the Magi, Christ's message of love extends to all and invites us to receive the gift of faith as we give the gift of ourselves. Since you acknowledge with joy that Christ has come and is present today, now is the time to hear his word so that you may possess eternal life by beginning in our company to know God and to love your neighbor. Are you ready to, with the help of God, to live this life? Sponsors, you now present these good people to us. Are you and all who are gathered with us ready to help Colleen, Glynis, Joseph, Ediana, Max, Jasenia, find and follow Christ?
We are.
Father of mercy, we thank you for these servants. You have sought and summoned them in many ways, and they have turned to seek you. You have called Colleen, Glynis, Joseph, Ediana, Max, Jasenia today, and they have answered in our presence.
Come and receive the sign of the cross. Receive the cross on your forehead. It is Christ who now strengthens you with this sign of love. Learn to know and follow Christ. Receive the sign of the cross on your ears, that you may hear the voice of the Lord. Receive the sign of the cross on your eyes, that you may see the glory of God. Receive the sign of the cross on your lips, that you may respond to the word of God. Receive the sign of the cross over your heart, that Christ may dwell there by faith. Receive the sign of the cross on your hands, that Christ may be known in the work which you do.
I sign you with the sign of eternal life, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we have signed Colleen, Glynis, Joseph, Ediana, Max, and Jasenia with the sign of Christ's cross. Protect them by its power, so that faithful to the grace which has begun in them, they may keep your commandments and come to the glory of rebirth in baptism. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. And now, receive this Bible. The words of our faith.
Now, with the angels, let us sing our gratitude for the presence of Christ in their lives. We have seen the star of your glory rising in splendor. The radiance of your incarnate word pierces the darkness that covers the earth and signals the dawn of peace and justice. Make radiant the lives of your people with that same brightness and beckon all the nations to walk as one in your light. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your word made flesh, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you, the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba, come, bearing gold and frankincense and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment. Lord, every nation on earth will justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. The kings of Tarshish and the isles shall offer gifts. The kings of Arabia and Saba shall bring tribute. All kings shall pay him homage. All nations shall serve him. Lord, every nation on earth will adore you. For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save. Lord, every nation on earth will adore.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes and the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" When Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance, he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out, and behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star. And on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary and his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened up their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord. So in the gospel this morning, it switches from those narratives that we've been listening to the last couple weeks from Luke's gospel to Matthew's. And what we have is kind of a story with all kinds of contrasts in it. For example, we have two kings in this story. We have the long-awaited newborn king of the Jews, foretold throughout the ages, the Christ, the Savior, the one who will reign over heaven and earth, the one whose reign will never end. And then there's that other king, King Herod, the paranoid king who, upon hearing of the news of this long-awaited Messiah, feels threatened. A king who has attained temporary earthly power and wealth, who will do anything that he can to hold on to it. And the paradox is that the one who has been born vulnerable, weak, and poor is the real power in the story. This is the one, this helpless one is God. You know, in the story, there are also two sets of wise men, if we think about it. We have those men that Herod consulted, those chief priests and the scribes, as to where the promised one was to be born. And then those other wise men, those foreigners who had come from a distant, traveled from a distant land to seek out the newborn king. And it is these Gentile wise men that travel to Bethlehem. And yet Herod's wise men, who should be welcoming this great news, remain where they are. They're not even curious as to whether what they're hearing is true, and they're not willing to move from their comfortable lives. You know, it's interesting, if you look at the infancy narratives in both Luke's and Matthew's gospel, it seems that whenever anyone encounters God's messenger, they end up traveling. Mary, upon being visited by the angel Gabriel, travels to her cousin Elizabeth's house. Joseph and Mary travel to Bethlehem, where Jesus is born in the throes of poverty. The shepherds in Luke's gospel and the Magi in Matthew's gospel that we just heard travel to Bethlehem to see this divine child and then travel back to their homes proclaiming the good news. Joseph takes Mary and Jesus to Egypt as refugees, no doubt encountering the suspicion and disdain that refugees often encounter. And when the Israelites, and then like the Israelites of old, they eventually travel back to Palestine, where they settle in Nazareth of Galilee. You know, in one sense, it seems like they've all been told that they need to go, but really, I think maybe a better way to put it is that each of them has been led. Seeing and hearing the voice of the Spirit in the signs above them, through the voices of angels, through the depths of their imaginations, in their dreams, leading them to where they needed to go. And it's not just physically that they're going, but also, and even more so, spiritually. And it wasn't that these journeys weren't without stress, weren't without confusion. It's not like these journeys weren't without challenges. And that's the thing about faith. That's the thing about coming to experience God in our lives. It's a journey where we have to move from a way of living and thinking, one way of living and thinking, to another. And it's about being open to being led. You know, this morning we've witnessed those in our RCIA program who are trying to be open to the Spirit in their lives. And we have seen them as people who have been led to us here. We've witnessed today their rite of acceptance, welcoming them into our community, affirming them in their seeking of the deepening of their faith, and also seeing in them models of our own need to continue to grow in our own faith. You know, if we're honest with ourselves, sometimes we can see in ourselves those wise men, those scribes and chief priests that Herod consulted. Sometimes we are people, upon hearing the good news, we are people who do hear the good news, but who are content with staying where we are spiritually, believing that we know everything that we need to know, satisfied where we are, thinking that we've grown all that we need to grow, believing that we no longer need to be led. And yet God still speaks to us through the stars, through those angels in our lives, and in the voices in our imagination that call to us. That call to us saying, follow me. Let me lead you to where you need to go.
We now profess our faith together using the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us now pray that the light of Christ's presence will reach out to the ends of the earth, touching all in need.
That those who lead the church are guided by the light of Christ in all their decisions, we pray.
Lord,
that leaders of nations will work to end all wars during this holy season of peace, we pray.
Lord,
that cultural and ethnic diversity may be celebrated as a true source of strength and harmony, we pray. That our new parish community may bring God's light to all we meet, we pray.
Lord,
that the light of God may guide us through the unknown as we rely more deeply on God's love and care for us, we pray.
Lord,
for all who are ill, weary, or burdened, that they might find strength, including Patrick Cibula, Patricia Crotty, Donald Pettis, Donald Pettis Edmund, Michael Gallo, Maggie Estacio, Patricia Reardon, Dennis Rusin, Baby Harrison Shinoni, Phyllis Skowerski, Phyllis Swanson, Fred Salmon, and Catherine Williams, we pray. For those who have died, that they may be one with Christ, especially Steve Sismar and Margaret Harmon, mother of Julia Harmon Bell and Don Harmon, we pray. For all the intentions being lifted up in our prayer circle, and in the silence of our hearts. And for the special intention of this Mass, Eugene M. DeSanto and family, Catherine and William Sargent, and Erica Dixon Johnson for healing, we pray.
God of light, you lead all people to your kingdom of hope and peace. Hear the prayers of your people and help us to see more clearly the mystery that is revealed in the coming of your Son, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn is Infant Holy, Infant Lowly, number 85 in your hymnal. Infant Holy, Infant Lowly, 85.
Infant holy, infant lowly, for his bed a cattle stall, oxen growing, little knowing, Christ the baby's Lord of all. Swift are winging, angels singing, Noel's ringing, tidings bringing, Christ the baby's Lord of all. Christ the baby's Lord of all. Flocks were sleeping, shepherds keeping vigil till the morning new. Saw the glory, heard the story, tidings of a gospel true. Thus rejoicing, free from sorrow, praises voicing, greet the morrow. Christ the baby's Lord of all. Christ the baby's Lord of all. As we journey to the stable, like the wise men long ago, we are hoping to discover what these pilgrims came to know. All are welcome at this manger, king and shepherd, friend and stranger, Christ the baby's Lord of all. Christ the baby's Lord of all. Wake our spirits from their slumber, send the darkness on its way. Fill our hearts with joy and wonder on this blessed Christmas day. Songs of angels all around us, grace and blessing now surround us. Christ the baby's Lord of all. Christ the baby's Lord of all.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Amen. Look with favor, Lord, on these gifts of your church, in which are offered now not gold or frankincense or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed, and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes. comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, all the clergy, those in religious life, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. Giles, St. Catherine of Siena, St. Lucy, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with each of you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is the First Noel on page 110 in your hymnal. The First Noel, 110.
And so it continued both
these three people.
Some announcements. Earlier this week, the emergency temporary shelter located at the St. Catherine St. Lucie Rectory opened. This effort, coordinated with Housing Forward, enables up to 15 homeless individuals a warm, safe place every night from 7 p.m. till 6:30 a.m. While the emergency shelter has opened, there is still a need for ongoing support. Volunteer opportunities exist. For more information, please see details in flock notes or call the office. Grief Share begins again on January 18th. If you or someone you know is mourning the loss of a loved one, please consider joining this group for support. Details are in the bulletin. Beginning January 22nd, a Sunday evening Mass will be offered at St. Edmund's at 5 p.m. This Mass is a joint effort between the two unified Oak Park parishes. Young adults are especially invited, but all are welcome. Save the date. The St. Catherine St. Lucie and St. Giles celebration of African American heritage will be on Sunday, February 5th. A special Mass will be offered at 10 a.m. and will be followed by a potluck brunch at St. Catherine St. Lucie campus. Have you heard of Pauli Murray? A legal trailblazer with pioneering contributions as a poet, activist, lawyer, and priest, you will not want to miss watching the documentary film My Name is Pauli Murray, and participating in our film discussion. This film will be shown in the small conference room in McDonough Hall at 7 p.m. on Monday, February 6th. In the spirit of Black History Month, Shelby Boblick and Maudette Carr will facilitate a discussion of the film on Tuesday, February 7th at 7 p.m. in McDonough Hall. Come to either or both sessions. Have you blessed your home for the new year? A beautiful tradition on Epiphany is to bless your home with chalk over the doorpost. Chalk is available in the back of church, and there are instructions and a blessing that you can use as well. Please take some on your way out. And have a wonderful Sunday.
Church, and I know it's the end of the Christmas season, but our masses do continue, so it's just very good to see you. And I ask God's special blessings to come upon our confirmandi and our candidates. May you continue to grow in the faith. May your sponsors continue to help you to grow, and may we look forward to the Easter Vigil when you will become full members of our Catholic faith. And now let us stand and conclude our prayer. The Lord be with you.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing.
May God, who has called you out of darkness into his wonderful light, pour out in kindness his blessing upon you and make your hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and be with you forever. Amen.
Let us go forth glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn is Joy to the World, number 82 in your hymnal. Joy to the World, 82.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing. Joy to the world, the Savior reigns. Bless us, our songs employ. While fields and floods, rocks, hills, and plains repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy, repeat, repeat the sounding joy. And makes the nations prove the glory of his righteousness and wonder of his love and wonders of his love and wonders, wonders of his love.
Have a good week. Talk to me about it after I. Have a good week.